Welcome back, winter, once again. And put on your warm fuzzy sweater, 'cause you'll feel much better when the snow.
Antarctic tundra is a biome located in the northern hemisphere, encircling the North Pole and extending south to the taiga biome.
Some abiotic factors of the tundra include strong winds, short summer days, a layer of permafrost, little precipitation, and long winters.
During the summers, there can be 24-hour daylight, resulting in explosive plant growth.
Plants in the tundra do not tend to grow very tall because of a layer of frozen soil underneath.
An example of plants that have adapted are the yellow tundra flower, which stores food for the winter.
Willows adapt to permafrost by growing a shallow root system, and the leaves adapt by growing long, fuzzy hairs.
Sedges have adapted by growing close to the ground, giving them warmth.
The liverwort has adapted by raising its capsule above the ground to help release its spores and have the rhizoids that absorb water.
And the woolly lousewort adapts with fine, dense hair to resist the cold by not only reducing wind chill, but by trapping heat from the sunlight.
The fauna of this biome is very diverse, and they each have several characteristics that make them fit for survival in the tundra. The Arctic fox, gray fox, wolverine, and muskox have all thick fur and small bodies that allow them to keep warm in the tundra.
One unique adaptation of the Arctic fox is it being able to shed its fur when summer comes in order for it to blend into the environment. The polar bear has black skin that allows it to absorb the sun.
The caribou and narwhal have a layer of fat that helps insulation for the body to keep warm. The Arctic owl and the colored lemming are both white in their fur and feathers that help them camouflage in the snow.
The Arctic owl is able to fire a spray hole and later spit up the adipocyte parts. All these organisms are part of an intricate food web that connects all of them.
Mutualism. An example of mutualism in the Arctic tundra is lichen. The fungal hyphae surrounds the algal cells, protecting it and providing it with water and salts. The algal returns, in return, provide the hyphae with sugars and oxygen.
Commensalism. The barren ground caribou and the Arctic fox have a commensalistic relationship. The fox follows the caribou, who removes the snow, covering it to get at the lichens underneath the soil. The fox then hunts the subnivian mammals that have been unearthed by the caribou.
Parasitic relationship. An example of parasitism in tundra is tapeworm in the caribou. The tapeworm takes in the nutrients in the caribou,
and the caribou dies.
The Centrum maculosa, known as the spotted knapweed, is the most invasive plant in the Arctic tundra.
This species is native to Eastern Europe and has invaded Northern America. It is found in recently disturbed sites and continues to spread into surrounding habitats.
This plant is hurtful to other plants around it because it is suspected to be allelopathic, which means it releases a toxin from its roots that stunts the growth of native nearby plants.
The climate in the tundra, as you may have guessed,
is very cold!
The average temperature in winter is negative 34 degrees Celsius. The average summer is 3 to 12 degrees Celsius.
Precipitation levels in the tundra are from 6 to 10 inches a year. Most of this falls to snow. In many ways, this biome is a cold desert lacking significant precipitation.
Because of these conditions, anyone who wishes to visit should bring a heavy winter jacket, thick boots that will not slip in the ice, and overall warm clothing.
Unless you want hypothermia and frostbite!
If you want to explore the icy tundra and all that it has to offer, then join us at the Snowfall Inn.
Our cozy environmental-friendly hotel will provide you with the various luxuries like a jacuzzi spa, hot cocoa cafeteria, and many bonfires.
Outside of the Snowfall Inn, you and your family can go whale watching around the glaciers, tour around our wildlife reserve, go dog sledding, and watch massive migrations of polar bears and caribou.
Also, a portion of the profits from our hotel we'll go to the biome's conservation.
We have to work together to protect this majestic area that is threatened by humans today.
Many endangered animals like the polar bear, muskox, and peregrine falcon are in trouble due to overhunting or changes in their natural habitat.
The polar ice caps are melting due to global warming. There are simple steps that you can take to help in avoiding major climate changes.
Always remember to recycle your garbage.
Try carpooling to avoid more carbon emissions spilling into the air.
And consider donating time or money to organizations that work towards helping our Earth.
The Arctic Tundra!
Let's go!
Party Rock is in the house tonight. Everybody just have a good time.
Yeah.
And we gon' make it look